What's up, YouTube? Trackless Master 2000.
PSP Master 19.
Yep. We're watching E3 doing these reaction videos and stuff. We watched Microsoft's, and so we're gonna do Microsoft's, Sony's, and hopefully Nintendo's. But there are some conferences tomorrow over stuff I gotta do. So hopefully I'm gonna rewatch it though probably. So yeah, we'll see about that.
I'll watch it live on my laptop.
Yeah. So. But we watched Microsoft's first. Sony's going to be tonight at 8, or at the recording of this video. I don't know when these videos will go off. Probably Tuesday or Wednesday, one of those days. But or maybe even tonight, who knows. We watched Microsoft's, and I can't say it's a joke yet because I haven't seen Sony's and Microsoft's, but I mean, I saw Sony's and Nintendo's, but Microsoft's was just, oh my god, it was horrible. I'm sorry to you Microsoft fans, but it's like, okay, I can commend them on showing game after game after game after game, because they did show a lot of games. Couple problems with it though. One, it's all Kinect. I don't see what the specialty with Kinect is. I don't see what the fad behind it. It's a fad. I don't think it's gonna last that long. But especially like, okay. The conference started off, let's see, I got the live vlog here. The conference started off with, like, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. You know, the guy came out playing it, and he was underwater, and, like, he put, like, a mine on the submarine, blew it up and stuff, then went above water on the boat, and everything was blowing out and stuff. It was pretty cool, but it's another Call of Duty, you know, who cares? Yeah, they made a mistake. The please reconnect controller, that was funny. But they got, you know, Gears 3. We knew that was coming. I'm not a Gears fan, so I don't really care. They got, oh yeah, Tomb Raider. The new Tomb Raider, the origin story. You're looking forward to that, right?
Yeah. Because it's like Uncharted.
Yeah.
It has a similar kind of gameplay for that.
It actually did remind me of Uncharted with the graphic style, like the motion capture.
Right.
And it's supposed to be like an origin story or whatever, but it actually looked pretty interesting.
And also, it's supposed to be a reboot, too, that's serious.
Yeah. But they're doing that a lot lately, with, yeah, like, Devil May Cry and stuff, unfortunately. But that game comes out in 2012. The only two games I care about, okay, for Halo, they got, midway through the conference, they announced Halo, the first game, remade, the anniversary edition or whatever you want to call it. It's remade for Xbox Live, Xbox 360, whatever, the first game. And at first I thought, why? Because it's a remake. Why not make a new game, you know? And then at the very end of the conference, they unveiled the big gun, which is Halo 4, the start of the new trilogy. So I thought, okay, this is cool. You know, you bring back the classic for Xbox 360, and then you get, you know, Halo 4 coming out to start the new game. Okay, it's cool. So that's pretty cool. So Halo 4, Halo Special Edition, and then maybe Tomb Raider, those are the only games I really cared about from the whole thing. They got, Kinect just dominated. I thought Kinect was retarded with the whole, like, everything. Like, they were playing, which game was it? Was it
Tom Clancy?
Tom Clancy, yeah. Where you gotta go, it's like, you can customize the gun, which is cool, but you can do that.
Well,
you get the gun. You customize your gun, right? And you're like, just rip it apart. You have to be like, and you rip it apart to the different parts. And then you can be like, and you get the camera viewing, which I thought that's pointless because you can be like, just use a joystick.
Right.
But it's like, if you just use a joystick to do the camera movement. But then when you want to use the gun, you got to close it like this, your arms. And I was like, okay. And then it becomes the gun, all customized with different parts and everything. And then you can throw it over your shoulder when you want to get in the game. Like, you go like this, and then you're like this. Like, literally, like with Kinect, like you're holding an invisible gun, and then you gotta just shoot, you gotta go. And I'm sitting here like, really? Really? Okay, just going through your living room, like.
There's also voice commands, too.
Yeah. The voice commands are cool for some games. Like, they were playing with golf, they got sport champion of that. Connect Sports Season 2. Season 2 was a gay title, I thought. but it's like, it's pretty much the second game, and it's like, but they were showing golf, and it's like, you know, in order to see above, you gotta go. And it's like, okay, or I can, you know, play Tiger Woods in the Wii, and I can just press up or whatever.
Speaking of Tiger Woods,
yeah.
The EA Sports stuff, remember?
Wait, which sports stuff?
When he said that the Kinect is also for all future EA Sports games, like the FIFA and the...
Oh, yeah. He said it was all future sports games on 360 will use Kinect, and all Tom Clancy games
in the future,
on the future will use Kinect, which is horrible. Like, this is my point. Like, I don't mean to go all badly here, but, like, when Nintendo with the Wii came out, people were like, oh, they're forcing motion control on us, which isn't true, because I played Brawl with a game controller. You know, Mario Galaxy used rubber controls. The only motion control you did is you just spin that and just shake it, what you do. I mean, it's just they have motion controls, they're not forced on you. But Kinect, that's exactly what they're doing. No one cares. Everyone thinks it's cool and fun. I've played Kinect. I mean, I don't care. Okay, some people may like it. That's cool. Me, I think it's really dumb. I like having a controller. I like motion controls, but I like having a controller. That's why I like the Move and I like the Wii better. But it's just, I just find some of this stuff ridiculous. Like, it's just like, okay, I'm going to throw the invisible gun on my back, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to be like, Oh, to see golf, to see the layout, I go, I'm not playing real golf, I'm playing in my living room. If I want to play real golf, I go out and play real golf. I want to play a video game. It's like, okay, the Wii is cool, because the Wii or the PlayStation or whatever is cool, because I can simulate it, but not the same. I mean, it's still a video game-wise. It's just, and it feels awkward with the golf, like, I mean, it's just like, it was a Kinect. You have to pretend it's there, whereas I can put a Wii remote or a Move in my hand, and it simulates it, but the voice controls are cool, because, like, the lady, she was trying to pick clubs for golf, and for the Kinect Sports Season 2, and she's like, switch clubs, the pitching wedge or whatever,
yeah,
and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, I thought that was kind of cool for the voice command. That was cool. But as far as doing this to see out, that's kind of dumb. Then you have to position yourself and stuff, you know, it's just, that's a little unnecessary to me. Let's see, what else? Star Wars is interesting because, like, I like how you use the Kinect to do the force moves. You can be like, lift shit and just, like, chuck it at people. That's cool. But it's like, first off, in order to move, you're doing this, like you dash forward. Which I already know is going to have problems with the Kinect, trying to recognize it. Like, you might do this, but you might be off, and it might jump you to the left, the right or something. And it's just, I know it's going to happen.
And there was lag issues, obviously.
Yeah, there was lag issues, too. I saw with golf, with the football, with quite a few games, there was lag issues. So, I mean, I already know. I mean, with Kinect, I mean, the technology still isn't there. I don't think. I mean, that's why you would need a controller, because it can sense it better instead of just sensing your body. They showed off the scanning thing, how you can scan stuff into the game and stuff like that, which I found cool. Only problem is they didn't really show what you can do with it. They said you can, like, get a skateboard and skate in a virtual world and stuff, but it's just I'd rather have if they can scan it, I'd rather have, like, a video game based on it. Like, you know, you have a, for example, if you have an open world game, and then you can scan whatever to, like, use that in the game world and stuff, that'd be cool. But so far, they scanned this, like, blue little pet thing, and you just kind of see it bounce around on the screen and stuff. And it's like, there could be more with that. There's potential behind it, but there could be more with it. They did the TV thing, too. Wait, what? What were you going to say?
I was going to say that they copied the 3DS for the Kinect.
Oh, yeah. They didn't do a lot of copying this year, but this one thing I found hilarious, the copy from the 3DS. No surprise, because Microsoft and Sony did that a lot from Nintendo. But the 3DS, when you make your Mii, you can take the camera, take a picture of your face, and your Mii will put the picture on his face, and he'll, you know, pull it off, and it'll be a copy. They did that with the avatars now, where, like, it does more, but it's still the same thing. You gotta position your face, and then you gotta position your body, and then it copies all that and stuff like that, which, you know, it's cool and all. I just found it funny that, you know, like, I'm not saying that's bad, because, you know, that's actually a good thing that Nintendo made, and it's kind of cool Microsoft's using it. I just find it funny how Microsoft and Sony and tons of other people are always like, oh yeah, we're innovative, yet, you know, they got that from Nintendo, so it's just, okay, I mean, whatever. I'm still not a big fan of avatars, because they don't do much. Mii's do a lot more. I'd be more a fan of avatars, because they do have more customizability. So I'd be more a fan of them if they were implemented in more games and in more apps and just more stuff in general. But there's not a lot of stuff compared to the Mii that you can do with them. That's why I like Mii better. But that's beside the point. They also, were showing the new Xbox Live thing, or the menus or whatever, how you have your music, because it's like the Kinect menus, or you have your music, you have your TV, I find it funny, so you can watch TV on the 360. 360 is connected to a TV. It's like, I can turn off the game system and just scroll through channels. I don't see what the point of it is. It is a little bit convenient to have, all your stuff on one system, but it's just, it's not that convenient. It's something that didn't need to be implemented, where they could take all those resources and work on more games. That's what I'm saying, more games. Going back to the games now, that's what I'm saying. The other problem I have, one problem was they were all about Kinect, which I just don't like. But another one was there wasn't a lot of variety. You still had a bunch of shooters, which yeah. I don't mind, but it's like okay, I pretty much wasn't surprised at anything they announced, because most everything they announced I saw Halo 4 coming. Even though Halo 4 I will look forward to, I saw that coming. I already knew they were showing off Tomb Raider, and I don't even think that they 360 exclusive, so that doesn't matter. Gears 3 was the big thing. They announced before they were showing Gears 3. I'm not a big Gears fan, I don't really care about Gears. Mass Effect 3. Yippee! I don't care about Mass Effect either. I don't care about a lot of big blockbuster games, that's what I'm saying. So, Mass Effect 3, what do they got? Modern Warfare 3.
It's
on PS3 and it might come to other systems. I wouldn't be surprised if it came to Project Cafe from Nintendo or the 3DS or NGP or anything like that. So that's what I'm saying. So that's not, that doesn't even count. I don't even know why they opened the conference with Modern Warfare 3. But it's just Call of Duty is the big thing nowadays. That'll end sooner or later, just like music games ended. But speaking of music games, Dance Central 2. Who gives a fuck? Who cares? It's just another dancing game. Seriously. Me, I don't care about Dance Central. I don't care about Just Dance and the Wii. I love the Wii, but I don't even care about Just Dance. Just Dance is dumb, in my opinion. The only dancing in my life is DDR, and any DDR equivalent. I don't like all these new things that are coming out.
DDR is classic. DDR
is classic. I love DDR.
It's been around in arcades for a very long time.
Yeah, exactly. And plus, I like the soundtrack for DDR, because DDR, you have more classic, arcadey, electronic music, whereas I don't like how Dance Central, it's more or less more popular music. The song they showed was Usher song or something.
DJ Fall in Love Again, I think it was called.
Yeah, it's like, I don't really care about that. And some DDR games, you can even make your own soundtrack, which I like better, so it's just, but that's just Dance Central 2, whoopee-doo. I wasn't really surprised by that either, but just, all of them were, there wasn't any big game that was announced. All of them was, there was that one, Dead Island, I think, or whatever that one weird game was. I wanted to chuck it out. But that's about it. It wasn't even that big. It looked interesting, but it wasn't like, oh, I gotta get this.
And I'm sorry, but, there was this Disney thing.
Yeah, the Disney and the Sesame Street game. I remember they announced it before E3, and there was tons of people saying, oh, these are going to be great. And I'm sitting there like, how are these people? If you like Disney stuff, great. But Sesame Street? What the fuck, man? They got this older guy, they're supposed to be representing the dad, and they got the little kid who's like 4 years old. They're playing the Sesame Street game. Open the book, you guys. I don't even remember the name. It's something book or something, but it's some book title. But
Once Upon a Monster.
Yeah, Once Upon a Monster. Yeah, you gotta open the book. You gotta go. Yeah, in front of business and crap. That's what the kid did. And then you're doing all this crap. Like you got these little floaty things, and you gotta.
And they're grabbing them.
I've seen this the last 2 years at Microsoft. They've been doing the freaking Kinect thing. I've seen this before, all this Kinect crap, okay? So it's more the same.